Hello friends, it's Brecky from Sustainable Prepping, your home for fear-free emergency preparedness on the internet. And today I am talking about my five favorite at-home disinfectants and how best to use them. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so glad you found my slice of the internet. And if you're not new, welcome back. I am so glad you're here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and give this video a big thumbs up. It lets me know that you want more fear-free emergency preparedness content. Today we're kicking off our month of sanitation and looking at different aspects of sanitation over in the Facebook group, which you can join if you look at the link down below. I'll have all the information there. But we're looking at different aspects of sanitation and why it's important to have a plan in place. So a couple of caveats before we begin. First, nothing that I'm talking about today is specifically for disinfecting your body, okay? Some of these can be used for that, but that's not what I'm talking about. We're specifically talking about disinfecting counters, door handles, floors, walls, whatever might need to be disinfected. That's what this is for. The second thing is that these should not be mixed. Now, there are some recipes where you can mix a few of these to create a stronger cleaner on the internet. But let me be clear that I am not recommending that you mix any of these with one another. These are meant to be used in isolation, okay? In isolation. The third caveat is that you need to make sure any disinfecting you do is done in a well-ventilated area. All of these are irritants, even vinegar, which is one of the ones I'll be talking about. And although it is not as caustic as other things, it can irritate the nasal passageways and the eye membranes if you're in an enclosed space. So to the best of your ability, always have ventilation. The last caveat is to use common sense. Not all of these cleaners can be used on every single surface or every single item. Don't go spraying your computer and drenching it in vinegar and then being mad when it doesn't work, okay? Use common sense, especially if you have certain kinds of hardwood floors, marble, things like that, things that have glossy finishes or stains on them. Some of these can eat away at those finishes or at even the marble, right? Vinegar can eat away at marble. So I want you to do your own research and use your own common sense when using any of these cleaners to disinfect an area. With those caveats in place so that you're using the wisdom of your brain, your good common sense, let's get started with my top five at-home disinfectants. All of these are made for home. These are all at-home use disinfectants. None of these are professional industrial grade. Number one is good old-fashioned hydrogen peroxide. Here is my bottle. And as you can see, I actually added a spray nozzle from another bottle, and actually an old water bottle spray that I had. This is a 3% solution, and 3% solution is about what you're gonna find at the grocery store or the drugstore. I think there are higher solutions that you can specialty order, but this is your standard, what you're going to get from the store. Hydrogen peroxide is great, particularly if you can do a little spray nozzle like this. It does have a disinfecting quality, a bacterial killing quality. I use this in my bathroom a lot to kill the sort of soap scum mold that gets in the creeks and crevices. A couple of things to note. For all of the disinfectants, you need to leave them on the surface for multiple minutes. All the research that I found suggests that you spray or drench the area with hydrogen peroxide and you leave it for 10 minutes to air dry, and then you can wipe off anything after that 10 minutes that hasn't already dried. This is going to need that time to kill the bacterium and the viruses that might be on your surface. So if you are spraying down a countertop, for example, you want to spray it and then leave it for 10 minutes. Most of us spray, we might leave it a minute or two, and then we wipe up almost immediately. And that's actually not allowing anything to work as well as it needs to. So when you're using a pure hydrogen peroxide solution, then you're going to want to let it wait for at least 10 minutes. Another way to use hydrogen peroxide is to just pour it into a bowl or a cup or a bucket, and to any cleansing cloths that you might need to disinfect to really get clean, you can just let them sit in there for 20 to 30 minutes and it will disinfect the fabric, the cloth that you put in there. I like hydrogen peroxide because it doesn't have a very caustic odor. It's very cheap and easy to get, and you can just buy a whole bunch of it and use it for a lot of different things. So hydrogen peroxide is my number one at-home recommended tool to have in your arsenal. Number two is isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol. Now, I list these two first because they're so common, they're so cheap, and they have a lot of different uses. Just like hydrogen peroxide, if you're going to use isopropyl alcohol to disinfect, you need to let it sit at least 10 minutes. Now, I've read that 70%, this is 50% if you want to see, but a 70% solution is actually better for disinfecting, as you can imagine. I didn't have access to 70%, so I have 50. So if I was going to be using this specifically for disinfecting, I would leave it for 15 minutes rather than 10 minutes. But again, just like with hydrogen peroxide, you just create a straight solution. You don't mix it with water. You spray it down on the surface and you let it sit 10 minutes for 70%, I would say 15 minutes for a 50%. But be careful, particularly with isopropyl alcohol, but really with any of these. Don't use them anywhere near an open flame, right? Nowhere near an open flame. These are highly flammable. And don't use them on something that's hot because it's flammable. So don't use it on a heater. Don't use it on something that's going to get hot while it's still damp, right? Use your common sense. But be smart. And isopropyl alcohol is a great tool to have on hand. You can use this to make your own hand sanitizer, for example. You can use this again in your medical kit, but you can also use this to clean surface areas that need to be disinfected. My third recommendation is a favorite of hippie home folks everywhere, and that, whoop, is white vinegar. You want to make sure that you're using a white vinegar of 5% acidity. Otherwise, it's not going to have the same killing action. This is why we don't recommend that any at-home vinegar that you make you used for cleaning. You can totally use it for cooking. You could use it for if you are really worried about cosmetic cleaning but not disinfecting. But if you want to disinfect with your cleaning, you're going to want to go to the store and get yourself some white vinegar. Oh. White vinegar is great. It's very non-toxic, so it's not going to hurt your kids if they get it in their mouths. It's not going to burn your hands. It can be irritating to the nose and eyes if you're in an enclosed space and you have a lot of, you know, vinegar fumes, but it's not going to hurt you. But here's the thing. You need to leave a fully soaked surface for 30 minutes if you want it to kill all the germs and bacteria, or more than 90% of the germs and bacteria. 30 minutes. Now, this is great for mopping if you're going to clean a floor, for example. If you want to drench down a bathroom, so you need a high volume of stuff and you can just let it sit and walk away. But it's important to think about if you're using vinegar, if you're planning on vinegar being your major at-home disinfectant, you need to plan for a 30-minute air dry. Otherwise, use vinegar for smaller cleanups, right? For maybe in between a big disinfecting wipe down. You can use this to clean your, you know, your counters every day, and then once a day or once every couple days, do a big disinfecting clean down with your hydrogen peroxide. I don't suggest using vinegar as your only method of disinfecting, frankly, because it's not as powerful. But if you do want to use it because it's what you have on hand, you might run out of other stuff. You need to drench the area. You need to thoroughly wet the area that you want to disinfect and leave it for at least 30 minutes to air dry before wiping it off. Okay? All right, my fourth recommendation is the first of the commercial brand cleaners, and that is either Lysol or Clorox. This is a non-bleach all-purpose cleaner. This is very caustic. It smells very strongly, definitely not something you want to spray in an enclosed space. I used this to clean my kitchen the other day after running out of my vinegar soap water solution that I use for an everyday basis, and man, my eyes were watering. We had to take the kids outside. Now, some websites say it only takes 3 minutes. Some websites say it takes as many as 10, I would say definitely spray this down and give it 3 to 5 minutes, okay? 3 minutes minimum, 5 minutes probably is best to truly and thoroughly disinfect an area. When we're talking about truly and thoroughly disinfecting an area, right, you really, if you have someone who's been sick, they've been vomiting, or they've had bodily fluids that are not where they're supposed to be, it's better to wait a little bit longer and have a more thorough clean than to be a little bit too hasty. Same thing goes if you're cooking with chicken, which might be at risk of salmonella, right, certain kinds of fish, that sort of stuff. You just really want to make sure everything stays nice and clean. I would say 3 to 5 minutes is your standard for Lysol or Clorox. I did not look at all the other, you know, off-brand options. I only looked at those two because those are the two that I use. So these are the non-bleach based cleaners. Make sure you store them in a safe place. Make sure you keep them away from children that can ingest them. While the other stuff would make kids sick, this will make them really, really, really sick. So just be mindful of how you're using these and who has access to them. They're not at the top of my list because they may or may not be available to you. They work. They are potent, but they are not always as available when we're talking about a serious situation. And there is some consideration about how long they stay efficacious. efficacious. There's some conversation that you get about a 1 year shelf life, maybe a 2 year shelf life if you haven't used it up by then. I would say you probably get a solid 1 year shelf life and then it gets to be a little bit iffy. But as far as using it today, a minimum of 3 minutes, 5 minutes is probably best to make sure you get a good, deep disinfecting clean. All right, my fifth and final recommendation are wipes. Wipes are so handy and so useful. Yes, I know that the sustainable part of me hates wipes because it's trash, right? You're just wiping things down with trash. However, there are some things that I think we need to throw away from our home. You wanna be able to clean it up and get that out of your house. And so wipes are really helpful. They're also really portable and they're less likely to be things that people get in their eyes, for example, and they tend to have less fumes. Wipes, I did some research, and again, it depends upon the brand. Now, this is an off-brand, right? This is the Kroger brand. Everything I've read says 2 to 5 minutes, and I'm gonna recommend the higher end of that, that you wipe something down so it's nice and damp, and then you leave it for 5 minutes. If you are intending for disinfecting, now you might wanna be cleaning just to get the dirt off. You're not cleaning to disinfect, in which case it doesn't really matter. But if you're trying to disinfect with wipes, you really need to thoroughly wipe down the area, the small area, and then let it sit and air dry for about 5 minutes for them to be efficacious. Again, these are only gonna work if you keep them well sealed. If the liquid evaporates out of your wipes, so does that disinfecting solution. You really wanna keep these nice and sealed so they can continue to provide the disinfecting moisture, the liquid, whenever you pull the wipe out and you clean your steering wheel or whatever it is that you are using to clean these with. Is it the most sustainable option? No, it's not the most sustainable option, but for the time being, it's what works for us, and it is my number 5 recommendation. Now, you might be noticing something that is missing, and that's bleach. I don't recommend people having bleach. I don't like bleach. I have some, but I don't like to use it. One, it's incredibly powerful, and you have to know how to dilute it properly in order to use it well. Bleach works really well. It only takes 1 to 2 minutes of a bleach solution sitting on a surface or having something soaking in a bleach solution for it to be disinfected. Okay, it's very, very powerful. But because it's powerful, it's very, very harmful. Bleach, if it's left near a mold, creates a harmful vapor that can kill you. If it gets on your skin, can burn the layers of your skin. Bleach is dangerous. So I don't really recommend it. Most of us don't know how to use bleach effectively, and it's just not on the top of my list. I have a little bit for emergencies, but I really don't use it. The second major issue with bleach is that it's only stable for about 6 months. After 6 months, it stops being as efficacious, so it's not as useful to have on hand. And a big container of bleach, unless you're bleaching towels or sheets or something on a regular basis, you're not gonna go through in 6 months before it stops being a stable compound. So I just don't love bleach. I don't know that we absolutely need to have it. However, I understand that sometimes you really do need to bring out the big guns. You need to purify water, you really have a big gross situation you need to take care of. If you're trying to treat a lot of sick people at home, you wanna make sure your linens are clean, your floors are clean, your surfaces are clean, your tools are clean. I get that. So my recommendation is actually to buy Pool Shock. This is the powdered chlorine. Basically, this is bleach in a powdered form that you mix with water. And that way you can mix a tiny bit and make a tiny amount, use it up, and then you're not having to store it. This is hazardous. This will absolutely make you sick, if not kill you, if you ingest it. So be mindful. You want to use bleach if you really want to have the big guns, okay? This is like the bazooka. This is the tank of at-home disinfectants. Then I would go with Pool Shock and I would get the ratios for making your own bleach solution so that you can make, you know, a couple of cups at a time rather than an entire gallon, and you know how much to make and you can mix it accordingly. You're gonna wanna make sure you have rubber gloves when you're doing any kind of major disinfecting solution, but this is my recommendation if you really wanna have bleach or something bleach-like, if you wanna have something that has an incredibly powerful disinfecting quality. There you have it, friends. Those are my top 5 and a very good bonus of at-home disinfectants. I hope this is helpful. Comment down below and let me know, do you have any of your favorite at-home disinfecting recommendations? I'd love to know what your options are. Again, I stayed away from bleach for my own personal reasons, but I'd love to hear your thoughts on bleach or other disinfectants. Don't forget to join our Facebook group. We are doing a deep dive into sanitation this month, and we are going to, I think next month, looking at lights and fuel sources. I'd love to have you come and join us. So I'm going to link down below to my free checklist. You are brand new to emergency preparedness and you want a bird's eye view checklist of things to work on, I'm gonna have that that link down below just for you, just as a thank you, totally free, because I want to empower people, particularly mamas, to have a fear-free emergency preparedness plan. I want you to feel good no matter what crisis is coming, because there's always going to be a crisis. I hope you're all well, and I'll see you next week.